Okay, so I'll also talk about the life cycle, so the HIV life cycle. So HIV as a condition itself is very easy to understand as well as answer if it is asked in one of the assessments or exams or the licensure exams. But when it comes to the life cycle, you need to understand it because it's a bit hard and you need to explain the 7 steps. So I'll start with step one. So on step one, it is also called the binding stage. So stage one in the life cycle of HIV, it's called the binding stage. So at this stage, you'll find that the HIV binds or attaches itself to the receptors on the surface of the CD4 cell. So it is going to attach to these receptors of the CD4 cell. That is the first step because it needs to attach to the CD4 cell. And you find that for the HIV virus to become active in the body of someone, it will need the presence of the CD4 cells. That's why it is going specifically to these CD4 cells. So once attachment occurs, fusion is going to take place, which is the second stage. So during fusion, the HIV envelope as well as the CD4 cell membrane, they fuse, or in other words, they join together, which allows the HIV to enter the CD4 cells. That's why you have drugs which are called fusion inhibitors because they inhibit this stage. Then from there, once fusion has taken place, you find that reverse transcriptase has to take place because the RNA of HIV has to be converted to DNA so that it's able to produce more HIV virus. So here on reverse transcriptase, which is the third stage, what happens is that inside the CD4 cell, the HIV releases and uses reverse transcriptase, which is an HIV enzyme, to convert its genetic material, HIV RNA, to HIV DNA. So here the conversion of the HIV RNA to HIV DNA allows the HIV to enter the CD4 cell nucleus and combine with the cell genetic material or the cell's DNA. So they combine, and that is why reverse transcriptase is important. So whenever you give drugs such as non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, as well as the nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, those drugs, they come to affect this stage so that this stage does not progress to the next stage. So what is happening here is that the HIV RNA is transcribed to HIV DNA, and then it enters the nucleus. And then we move on to stage four in the life cycle of HIV. So on stage four, it is also called the integration stage. So on this particular stage, inside the CD4 cell nucleus, the HIV releases the integrase enzyme, which is an HIV enzyme. HIV uses the integrase to insert its viral DNA into the DNA of the CD4 cells, and the integration will take place. So here you see that the CD4 cell DNA as well as the HIV DNA mix together or combine, which we are calling integrating. From there, we even move on to stage five, which is called the replication stage. So on stage five, it is called the replication stage, and here, once integrated into the CD4 cell DNA, HIV begins to use the machinery of the CD4 cell to make long chains of HIV proteins. And these protein chains are the building blocks for the HIV itself. Then we even move on to stage six, and stage six is called the assembly because at this stage, the HIV proteins have already been produced. So during assembly, the new HIV proteins and as well as the HIV RNA move to the surface of the cell and assemble into immature HIV. But as they assemble at this stage, at stage six, this HIV is still inactive because if it becomes active, it is going to reverse the process and go back to the nucleus. That's why it remains inactive. And then at this particular point, we move on to the last stage, which is the seventh stage. And this stage is also called the budding stage. So during the budding stage, the newly formed immature, which is also non-infectious HIV, virus, it pushes itself out of the host CD4 cell. And here the newly HIV releases the protease, which is an HIV enzyme. So the protease breaks up the long chain protein in the immature virus, creating the mature infectious virus. So once this mature infectious virus is released back in the blood, and here you find that we have drugs which are called protease inhibitors. So those drugs, they inhibit this particular stage. But once the virus finds itself back in the blood, it will now start also searching for the new CD4 cell, and the process will continue. So this is how the life cycle of HIV occurs. So thank you so much for taking time to go through the video. We'll see you next time as we talk about other cycles.